Hi, I'm Black Library author Jude Reid, and I'm here to reveal my new novel, Morvenn Vahl, Spear of Faith. My new book, Morvenn Vahl, Spear of Faith, follows Morvenn Vahl, who's High Lord of Terra and Abbess Sanctorum of the Adepta Sororitas at the point that we meet her. She's a political appointee to the job, and she doesn't have a great deal of faith in herself when we start the novel, but all of that comes to a head when Ophelia 7, which is the planet of the Adepta Sororitas, comes under attack, and that's a shadowy figure called the Death of Saints, who's come to attack the planet. So Morvenn's placed in a position where she's caught between her political obligations and her duty to her sisters. And the book's about the choices that she makes in defence of that world and the sacrifices she has to make to hold it. Writing about High Lord of Terra is obviously a huge obligation because they're such a big part of the setting and they come with so much baggage attached to them. We haven't seen Morvenn very much. She's appeared in a few codexes, and obviously this is her first appearance in a Warhammer novel. It was a balance of trying to meet those expectations about what's already been established about the character and allowing her to really grow and develop as a real person on the page. She's an interesting character because at no point where she's appeared has she been the focus of any miracles. And she's been appointed by the High Lords of Terra as someone who they think will be inexperienced, someone who they think will be malleable. And we know very rapidly that that's not the case. She's somebody who takes on the mantle, she makes it her own. And for inspiration, obviously, I looked at a lot of religious women from history, a lot of warrior women from history. So looking at Eleanor of Aquitaine, Julian of Norwich, another famous mystic whose religion was very much the focus of her life. So it was nice to have the chance to really develop the character, to try and work out why she is the way that she is. This sort of shining beacon of faith, leading an army of warrior saints who's not in herself a focus of miracles. There was a big difference in writing about Ursula Creed and also writing about Morvenn Vahl. They are both very powerful women. They're both leaders of huge armies. They're both very accomplished warriors in their own rights, but their background is very different and their motivations are very different. Ursula, like all Cadians, is very much shaped by the loss of Cadia and all those dramatic events. Morvenn has grown up as one of the Adepta Sororitas. She's never known another life. So all of her life is hinged around faith and her relationship with the God Emperor and her relationship with her other sisters. And while Ursula was someone who knew what she wanted to achieve, who'd set out with every professional decision she'd ever made to become the head of the Cadian armies, Morvenn's someone who's really been thrust into this position, someone who never expected to be the anointed leader of the Adepta Sororitas, but she's someone that's kind of got to make good and just doing her best for the God Emperor and for her sisters and for the Imperium as best she can. Doubt is one of the big themes of Morvenn Vahl, Spear of Faith, but it's not doubt in the God Emperor. Her faith is never tried. Her doubt hinges around whether she's worthy of this tremendous honour that she's been given, whether she has the skills, and whether that appointment is made for the right reasons, because she's fairly cynical about the reasons why she's in the job. But now she's there, she's going to make the best of it. Without giving away too many spoilers, the antagonists, the Night Lords in Morvenn Vahl's Spear of Faith, are something that I had a lot of fun with. And the main antagonist is a character called Col Rakul, the Death of Saints. And he's almost a legendary figure who's come out of the history of the Argent Shroud, sworn to kill them all, to burn their temples, to destroy every trace of the Argent Shroud. And the conflict, the central conflict of the book is between Morvenn and the Death of Saints. And I think the bit I enjoyed most writing about the book, although I enjoyed it all, is drilling into why exactly he is the way he is and why he's not a mindless killer. And there are elements where I even had a bit of sympathy for him. Writing about the Night Lords and an army that uses terror as their prime weapon was absolutely wonderful. The thing that drew me to them in the first place, partly, obviously, the books about the Night Lords by Aaron Dembski Bowden, which I've been a massive fan of for years. But the visual contrast between the gleaming silver armour of the Argent Shroud and the dark blue armour of the Night Lords was just so visually appealing in the first instance. And on the one hand, superficially, they couldn't be more different. These shining beacons of imperial faith and these corrupted heretic Astartes who are sowing terror and discord almost just for the sake of it. But when you drill down into it, there's a lot of horrific things that the Adeptus Sororitas do. And I absolutely loved drawing the comparison between the actions that they both take. And obviously they're very, very different goals, but for the ordinary people of the Imperium, both are very much figures of terror. It's just slightly different in how they approach things. It certainly starts with some political intrigue, but there's plenty of action that starts coming and just keeps coming for the rest of it.